Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Let us discuss how to do the projections of the given solid. It is a pentagonal prism. Let us take the given question. A pentagonal prism of base edge 30 mm and axis 60 mm rest on an edge of its base in the HP full stop. Its axis is parallel to VP and inclined at 45 degrees to HP. Draw its projections. Here projections means we have to do front view of the given object and top view of the given object. Two views we have to do. Okay, those are front view and top view of the given pentagonal prism. Okay, here we are writing HP and VP. HP means horizontal plane, VP means vertical plane. Here as I told, we are taking the solid, it is a pentagonal prism. So this is the model of the pentagonal prism. Okay, here if you see it has five sides, we can call it as pentagon. And this side also it has five sides. Okay, it is also pentagon. These two are the bottom surface and top surface. Okay, we can call this is a base also, base of the prism. And these two faces are connected with the help of one more face. Here this face is called rectangular face. So these two pentagons are connected with the rectangular faces. Okay, if you see here, all are rectangular faces. So how many rectangular faces are there? Each side of the polygon has one rectangular face. Okay, so like that five faces are there. Like that five sides of the pentagon has five rectangular faces. Okay, and now here the given data is base edge is 3 cm. Okay, here I told it is a base. Okay, one of the edge is 3 cm. Always remember, in solids we are considering the polygons, whatever polygons we are taking, those are regular polygons. Regular polygons means all sides has equal length. This side 3, this side also 3, 3, 3, okay, 3 centimeter, 3, here also 3. All sides has equal length and angle at all the corners also same. Okay, for all polygons. Okay, here we are taking the regular pentagon. Okay, base edge means one of the edge length is given, it is 3 centimeter. The meaning is all edges has 3 centimeters. Okay, and axis is 6 centimeters. Axis means roughly I did here the center of this polygon. Okay, let us take this is the center of the pentagon, and here center of this pentagon bottom face. So if you join two centers with imaginary line, it is called axis. Okay, axis we are doing two big lines with a dot, two big lines with a dot. Okay, so here also I did axis line, two big lines with a dot. Okay, it is an imaginary line which is joining two centers. Okay, top surface and bottom surface centers it is joining, and we are giving this center distance is called height of the axis, height of the solid. Okay, we can call it as axis also. It is 6 cm. So this prism height is 6 cm. Got it? Before doing the projections, first take the given conditions. So here the first condition I have written here, edge of the base is in the HP. Next condition is axis is parallel to VP and inclined at 45 degrees to the HP, and this axis is inclined at 45 degrees to HP. Instead of taking all the three conditions, take the first condition. One of the edge of the base is in the HP. What I am assuming, all the edges of the base, okay, how many edges? Five edges on the HP. Okay, this is the first assumption. In it we have to assume like that. Okay, now for this condition we have to do the front view and top view. We have to do the projections in this case. Okay, now for showing the projections, here I am taking, this is a vertical plane, this is a horizontal plane. I am keeping these two planes in the 3D form like this. Okay, and the line joining both the planes is this line. Okay, I am giving this line is the reference line or XY line. If you are keeping in 3D view, okay, this is the first quadrant. This is a horizontal plane, this is a vertical plane. We are keeping the solid like this. Okay, so here one, this edge is on the HP. I am assuming like that. I am keeping all the edges in the HP on the horizontal plane. We need to do the projections of it. Top view of this prism and the front view of this prism. If you see from top, okay, we can see this polygon or pentagon on the horizontal plane. So on horizontal plane, we can see the top view. Here I have written. First do the top view here. This roughly I am doing here. So both pentagons, this pentagon and the bottom of pentagon are coming at the same polygon here. Okay. For the top surface, I will give 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. For the bottom surface, at 1, I will give A, B, C, D like that. Okay. So A and 1 here, A here, both are coming at the same point. Now mark the points here. Let us assume we are giving 1 comma A, small letters, okay, alphabets. Here let us take, this is 2 comma B, 3 comma C, 4 comma D, 5 comma E. So this is the top of the prism, like this. And then we have to do the front view also. Here remember one thing, this gap is not given, we can take any gap. Okay, after XY line, we can take any gap, do this polygon, okay. After that, do the front view of this prism. In the front view, okay, here we can see this edge, okay, this rectangular face and this inclined rectangular face. Forgetting it, just do the projections of it. Tilt this horizontal plane in downward direction like this. Both views will come here. So in vertical plane, we can see the front view. Okay, forgetting the front view, just do the projector lines like this. Okay, and give the names here. Okay, for the bottom surface, as I told, I'm giving alphabets A dash here, B dash, E dash here, C dash, D dash. Okay, front view, in this front view, we can see this entire height. How much height of the polygon? It has given 6 centimeters. Okay, from where it will start? So above XY line. Okay, so here above XY line, take 6 centimeters vertical height of the prism like this, and here also we can see this rectangle. Okay, and here mark the points. At A it is 1 dash, here 2 dash, 5 dash, here 3 dash, 4 dash. Okay, for the top surface I am giving numbers, for the bottom surface I am giving the alphabets. Okay, like this. Here, if you see here, this is 3, this is 4, this is C, this is D. Okay, C, D are coming at the same point, and 3, 4 are coming at the same point. Here I have marked. Similarly, this is 2, this is 5, 2, 5 are coming at the same point. Okay, so this is the front view. Okay, so this is the first condition. And next condition is axis is parallel to VP. Okay, in this case also, if you see here, axis means, as I told, it is a center line like this. Okay, imaginary line. This line is vertical. Okay, so it is parallel to the vertical plane only. Okay, and next case is, and the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to HP. Now axis is like this, vertical as I told. Again, it is inclined to 45 degrees angle to the horizontal plane like this. Okay, what we are doing, whatever front view is there in this case, we are tilting the entire front view 45 degrees. Okay, this front view we are tilting 45 degrees. Let us take this side. It is tilting 45. Let us assume this edge is on the horizontal plane only. We are keeping like this line. So this edge is on the HP only. It is tilting like this. Okay, which is this edge? C dash, D dash. Okay. Now keep this edge on the horizontal plane only. It is tilting like this. Whatever this edge, we are marking the same here also. C dash, D dash. And mark this length here. 3 dash, 4 dash. The build the entire rectangle here like this, and mark this length on the base B dash, E dash. Here do the parallel line, parallel to this 2 dash, 5 dash. This is 1 dash. Here also mark these points A dash. Now forgetting the final top view, do the projector lines from all the points. From here also do the projector lines from all the points. Okay, take the intersection points, do the final top view. So for doing it in the sheet, use pencil. Okay, so let us do the final top view and all these positions in the sheet. First do the XY line of any length. Okay, by using scale, first do the XY line. Of any length, mark x comma y, After that, take any gap here, build this polygon. Okay. So first, initially, I will take this 3 cm line at some gap. Okay. So how to take polygon here? As we know, outer angle formula. This angle is outer angle 360 by n. N means 5, number of sides. It is 72 degrees, and this angle is also 72 degrees. This angle 72. All outer angles. This angle 72 degrees. Okay, and if you are taking this angle, or if you are taking here, if you extend this line, this angle is also 72. Okay, like that we can build the polygon. Here in this, take 3 cm line. So this edge is perpendicular to it. Just take, this is 90, take just one perpendicular line. On it, take 3 cm. Now here by using this protractor, take this inclined line, this angle is 72. So here 70, 71, 72. So in this direction, take 3 cm line. Now this side also 72 degrees. Now here also take 72. So in this direction 3 cm line. Let us check this closed side is 3 cm or not. Now it is 3 cm. So this is the given polygon. Mark points 1, A and then 2, B, 3, C, 4, D, 5, E. We are doing the polygon. Find the center of this polygon. How to find the center of the polygon? Take any two adjacent sides. Do the perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisector means here we have to do the perpendicular line at the middle point. Okay. And here also we have to do the perpendicular line perpendicular to this. Okay. And here also at the middle point do the perpendicular line. The intersection point is the center for the given polygon. Try to do. Here we have one process of doing the perpendicular bisector. Okay. Let us take these two sides. Here take the radius more than half of the length. Okay. Is it more than half of this length? Yes, approximately. Just do one arc this side and one arc this side. And same radius, this as center. Cut this arc, cut this arc. Here extend this arc this side like this. So here whatever line is coming by joining two points, it is a perpendicular bisector for this. Try to do it. Join these two intersection points with the help of scale. Here roughly do. Here I did the line. Okay. And after that follow the same process for this also. Here also take more than half of the radius. Do one arc here. And do another arc here. And same radius. This as center, cut this arc. And then cut this arc. Join these two intersection points. You will get another perpendicular bisector. Extend it. Okay. This is one perpendicular bisector. This is another perpendicular bisector. The intersection point of both perpendicular bisectors is the center of this polygon. Okay. Here mark this name is for the center of the base is, let us take O1. Okay, the center is O1 here. For this take center is O2. So in the top view both centers are coming at the same point, O1 and O2. Okay, you can keep comma also. So after getting it, do the projector lines from all the points. This is the reference line. Always remember projector line should be in light color. So after getting it, mark the intersection points, that is alphabets A dash, here B dash, E dash, here C dash, D dash. At the center also do the axis line. Axis line, as I told, it is the two big lines with a dot. This is the axis line. Okay, we did up to some length. Here mark this length above XY line. What is the height of the prism? 6 centimeters given. So take that height, 6 centimeters. Mark the end point, extend this line. And here mark the points center for the bottom one. I am taking O2 dash, here O1 dash, and here this sides also do the lines of 6 centimeters. So here join this, take this as a reference, join all the endpoints. Here mark the intersection points 1 dash, 2 dash, 5 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash. This is the top view, this is the front view. In next case, the entire front view is tilting 45 degrees. Okay, that is axis is making 45. So here take any point, mark this point here. C dash, D dash, here take 45 degrees. Do one line here of 6 centimeters. Okay, the entire height is tilting. Okay, and height is 6 centimeters. So this point is 3 dash, 4 dash. Okay, and here C dash, D dash. Now this base is 90 degrees as we know, okay. Now here also do the line 90 degrees to this. So in this direction, do this, do the line. Okay, on it mark this length by using compass. Mark this length. Okay, this point is A dash, and then mark this length also. This is B dash, E dash, and mark this center also. So here at all the points do the parallel lines to this line of 66 centimeters. Okay. Here axis line, two big lines with a dot like this, up to 6. Now here do the line parallel to this. Mark the intersection points. This point is 1 dash. Now this point is 2 dash, 5 dash. This point is O1 dash. Okay, here after getting the front view, do the projectile lines from all the points. Take any one of the vertical line is the reference line. From these points also do the projectile lines. Take this is a reference. here for the center also do the projector line. Now after getting this, mark the intersection points. A horizontal line, A vertical line, mark this is small a. Similarly B vertical line and then B horizontal line, mark B point here. C horizontal line, C vertical line, mark C. D horizontal line, D vertical line, mark B. E vertical line, E horizontal line, mark E. And O2 vertical line, O2 horizontal line, mark this is O2 center. Similarly mark 1, 2, 3 also. 1 vertical line, 1 horizontal line, mark 1 here. 2 vertical line, 2 horizontal line, mark 2 here. 3 horizontal line, 3 vertical line, 3. 4 horizontal line, 4 vertical line, 4. 5 vertical line, 5 horizontal line, mark 5. And then O1 center here, O1 horizontal line, mark this is O1. Okay, like that we are getting number of points. In it, do the outer points with continuous lines. What are the outer points? A, B, 2, 3, 4, 5, E are the outer points. Do with continuous lines. Always remember, with the help of scale, join outer points with the continuous lines. I will do with another color so that it is visible for all of you. Okay. Join AB with scale. And then B2 is also with scale. And then C3. 3, 4. 4, 5. 5E. 8E. After joining all outer points with continuous lines, here just take top view of it. Okay, top view means we can see this portion. Okay, if you are taking this prism, if it is tilting like this, so this top view we are doing here, we can see this entire surface. So do this 1, 2, 3, 4 with continuous lines here. So join with continuous lines. 5, 1 here. And then 1, 2. Okay, after that, so in the top view we can see this pentagon. And then we can see this 1 and A edge. Okay, if you see from top like this arrow, we can see this edge 1 and A. Okay, do with continuous line. 1A, if you take this 1A, we can see, just now I did here. 2B also we can see, 2B already we have one line. This edge we can't see from the top. Okay, so which is this face? 3C. Okay, where is 3C? 3 and here C, it is a dotted line. Okay, do with scale. Invisible edge, 3C is the invisible edge. Also 4D, 4D is also invisible, 4D. Like this, and then here we can see this polygon like this, reduced polygon, and this polygon, this part we can see here, we did the remaining part of the polygon we can't see, this one. Okay, so as we know polygon is A, B, C, D, E. Okay, join the remaining one with dotted. This is the invisible part. And always remember, in solids first join all outer points with continuous line, and this top surface, from the top we can see whatever number lines are there, do with the continuous lines. Here whatever bottom surface is coming, do with dotted. So after getting projections, mark the dimensions, given dimensions correctly. Side length is 30 mm and axis is 60, and this inclined angle is 45 degrees. The other video lectures of this projections of solids, I will give video link in description box. Please check it. Always remember, do with pencil in the sheet all the four diagrams. Just for getting the clear view, I am using the pens. If you like this lecture, please subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.